The key for all of these things happening is that the presence of God, the working of the Holy Spirit, had to be in place. Can I tell you that if we want to see God work miracles in our families, in our church, at our workplace, we must be dependent upon the working of the Holy Spirit. We cannot accomplish spiritual thing with human effort. I don't care how smart you are, how logical you are, how brilliant you are, unless the anointing of God touches what your gifting is, it will never result in spiritual accomplishment. But there's great news for you today. The power of the Holy Spirit is not only available, but it's recommended, it's provided, it's encouraged for every believer to be filled with the Spirit of God. I want to tell every one of you here today, God doesn't want you to limp through life. As a matter of fact, in January, I'm working on a series. We're going to have sermons right now talking about the dream life. God wants you to have the kind of life you've always dreamed of, but it may not be what you think it is. What God wants you to have is to be filled with the Spirit of God so you have the abundance of joy that we're going to look at here this morning. As a matter of fact, it's the Spirit of God that always accomplishes the impossible. It's the Spirit of God that saves the vilest of all sinners, amen? It's the Spirit of God that softens that rock-hard heart that has become solidified through bitterness where there's no softness at all, and the Spirit of God comes and transforms it, amen? It's the Spirit of God that gives you wisdom and direction when you seek answers. It's the Spirit of God that gives you strength to keep going on when you feel like quitting. It's the Spirit of God that gives you boldness and courage even when you're facing difficulty and adversity and opposition. It is the Spirit of God that gives us the ability to accomplish things beyond our human nature. As we look at this section here today, it is a response of joy to the goodness of God. Look at it with me. I got some verses there for you to see. 1 Peter 1, 8 and 9. You loved him even though you've never seen him. Though you do not see him now, you trust him and you rejoice with a glorious, inexpressible joy. I've said this so many times, but I want to just push this into your heart of understanding today. For you to claim to be a follower of Jesus Christ and to walk around with a joyless experience is sin. It's sinful. When non-Christians look at you and they don't see joy in your life, you are not a good representative of Jesus Christ. You say, well, how did I get the joy? Well, there's a whole lot to it, but let me just tell you this. When you are filled with the Spirit, the Holy Spirit produces within you love, joy, and peace. You know, too often, I'm just telling you, there are too many Christians who are living in the poverty level of life instead of the abundance God wants you to have. And when you talk about abundance, there are too many small-minded, materialistic people who think, oh, he's telling us we can have more money and a bigger house and nicer cars. Listen, that stuff all fades away. I got something better than material things. I'm talking about a joy that causes you to sing at midnight even in the jail cell. I'm talking about a joy that nobody can take away from you. That's what the Holy Spirit will put in you. How many of you want that kind of joy? Say amen.